There is nothing romantic about the wave of modern-day pirates attacking commercial ships in the waters off Somalia. Combined Task Force 151, a UN-authorized multinational military operation, now patrols the Gulf of Aden and has detained some suspected pirates, many of them Somalis, who say they're trying to defend their waters from foreign fishing ships and have ended up demanding ransoms as a way to earn money. But in an area that covers hundreds of thousands of square kilometers, the task force can't be everywhere, and that's created an opportunity for private security companies.
People who've got an investment, who have a ship loaded with, I don't know, with PlayStations or whatever it may be, they have to protect that investment. So if the navies of the world can't protect them, they will turn immediately to the private security industry.
About 50 companies in the UK and the US, including some with private security experience in Iraq, have begun offering sea-based protection services. This is the MacArthur, owned by the American security firm once known as Blackwater. It offers what it calls water and air-based escort services to container ships and commercial tankers, vessels that, by their very design, are slow and hard-pressed to evade attackers in speedboats. One British company sells fishing nets that it says make it impossible for would-be pirates to board and take control of ships. Another possible alternative comes with legal and safety concerns, letting commercial sailors carry guns on board.
If you're carrying a gun, the bad guy can always have a bigger gun. And where do you end up in that sort of escalation?
The pressure to self-protect comes not just from the need to avoid hostage situations or multi-million dollar ransom payments. There's also pressure from insurance companies who want to reduce their risk. Shipping companies that can show they've tried to guard against piracy can pay lower insurance premiums. But is any of this the answer to preventing future pirate attacks? Ultimately, legal experts and security companies alike say the answer lies on land, in efforts to restore the rule of law in Somalia, home of the modern-day pirates. Rosalind Jordan, Al Jazeera.